Well, hello everyone. So today I decided that I wanted to paint with oils. And I think we're gonna do like a landscape. I really don't know, I'm just gonna go with it. So let's see what I create. First I'm gonna start with a small flat brush. And we're gonna put the sky in okay. So a little bit of blue for the sky. Oh, I hope it turns out good. Now, with oil paints, instead of water to thin out the paint, I'm going to use an odorless thinner. I'm not exactly sure what it's called. But, so I dip my paintbrush in a little bit of the odorless thinner, so that this can spread a little easier. Okay, so I'm just putting the sky in here. I'm gonna grab a little bit of red. Blend that into the sky. Oil paints for me are really fun to work with. I love using oil paints. They're one of my favorite, probably my favorite thing to paint with. But it's just, they're so messy, super messy, but they blend just because they don't dry as quickly as acrylics do. I have more working time with them. They dry super slow, like days it takes for this to dry. But you can't blend the way you blend. You can't blend acrylics the way you can blend oil paints. And that's the fun thing about oil paints for me. Okay. Okay, maybe some water. I'm gonna bring it in through the sides, just like this. And then from this side also. don't worry too much about these fingerprints. I made the picture a little bit bigger so I can cut the sides off. But they do bother me. Okay, see how awesome that already looks? Okay, so I'm gonna wipe my brush, or I'm gonna clean it off first in some paint thinner, and then wipe it on my paper towel, or my... my towel. And I'm gonna use, let's see what brush, this brush. It's just a bristle brush, and I'm gonna use this to add some clouds. So, just with a little bit of white on the brush, I'm just gonna go for it. Let's put some clouds in here. And I'm just gonna scrub these in. Scrub, scrub, scrub. Scrub in the clouds. Ooh, it's got some red tint in it. I like it, it looks awesome. More white. Amazing. A little bit more for this one. Okay. I think that looks pretty good. I'm gonna make them stand out a little more. You can work on these clouds for a long time. Get them exactly the way you want them. Wipe the brush off, get some of that paint off, so I can blend a little better these. Mountain, how about purple mountain? So I'm gonna use this brush. Let's see what happens. So, some purple paint, a little bit of black, to make it kind of dark. Okay, and I'm going to put in a mountain. Put it in right here. Now we got our mountain in. Pull it out. Kind of make it fade away. All right, so now we are gonna add our highlights. So with a little bit, so I'm gonna grab some white. And I got some purple in there already, maybe a little bit of pink. Let's see if this works. Now, load up my brush like this, and I'm gonna add some snow to this side of the mountain. Some more white. Hey, no, that's dirty water. Sorry, my dogs are drinking out of the water I paint with. Little brats, they have their own. Okay, I think that worked. And I'm just going to blend that in, kind of tap it in so it blends into the mountain. Always go back. See, that's why I like oil paints, because you can always go back. I mean, you could do this with acrylics too, but oil paints is just so much easier for me anyway. It might not be like that for everyone. So it kind of worked. Not using a palette knife. I'd say that worked out all right. I'm just using the corner of my brush to bring this down. Flip it this way. kind of got rid of my peak there. I did not want to do that. Okay, so tap it in a little bit again. Okay, and now I'm gonna create a little bit of a highlight from behind. So I'm just gonna grab a little bit of blue and mix it in with the white that we had already made. And I'm gonna come in and add a bit of a reflection from the backside. And I'm doing this with the corner of this brush. A bit more white and blue. Okay, I think we're good with that. Put in here. I guess we can put like a heel or something. So I'm gonna get some green. Okay, a little bit of black. Black and green. Make it a little bit darker. And let's put in a hill. Okay, hope I don't ruin this beautiful mountain. If not, this mountain is done. That's how you paint a mountain. Good. That's all I'll put on the video. But if... Okay, let's go. Alright. Let's put this in. I don't know what I'm doing. Okay, let's put in another mountain, but we'll use more green. Maybe some white, if I can grab it. No, we want it darker. See, I'm telling you. So before you do that, see, I knew this was gonna happen. You gotta tap this in. And the reason we wanna tap this in is because we wanna create mist so that it looks like it is far away. Okay, that looks good. I like it. We'll keep it that way. And this one's getting closer, so I'm gonna add a little bit more black to this. The closer the things come to you, the darker they are. The next time you go look at mountains and you're far away, you're gonna see them. You're gonna see that the farther they are away from you, the lighter they are. And the closer they are to you, the darker they are. So there's that. And I'm just going to tap this one. Okay. Should I create one more? I could create one more, but this time I'll put more black into this. Ooh, I think I put too much black. Too much black. More green. More green, more green. And this, we'll use this to create before I do that though. Pull this down. Because we want to create the illusion of water back here. Okay, so now I can add whatever I'm going to be adding to the foreground of this picture. So I guess we could add something here. Ooh, I always get so nervous putting this stuff in. Put in some trees. Using this fan brush, it's a bristle fan brush. And I'm gonna add a tree. I'm gonna use, well, should I use brown? Maybe I should use some brown. So I'm gonna grab some brown. So it's a mixture of brown and leaving some of the green in there. Really dark. It's a really dark color. And I add my tree. So this tree, I'm gonna put it. Okay, let's make it right here. I know you can't really see. I put all my paint here. I shouldn't have. Let's see. Okay, so. Okay, I'm gonna put it like this. Whoops. It's a crooked tree. But I like crooked trees. My tree. Maybe we'll make another tree. We'll make this one straight and all the way to the top. So we'll come here and then add some pressure. Two trees. Okay. Now that we've done that, I'm gonna get some more. I'm not even gonna clean the brush. I'm just gonna grab some green. Some more green. Some black to mix with my green to make it darker. Fill up the brush, both sides, and add do that same thing to this one. Take your time with this. It might cover some of your clouds, but that's okay. It got kind of light, and I think that was because of my cloud. Picked up some of that white that was back there. So what I'm gonna do is add some more dark to it. Cool. Nice. That looks awesome. Some yellow, lighten up this. We're gonna highlight the tree, if it'll let me. Oops. May have gotten too much, but that's okay. Okay, now that I've done that, I'm going to wipe off my brush. Whoops. Did I mess it up? So I'm gonna use this color. I'm gonna mix it with the brown. Just any dark color. That might not be enough, but let's see. And we're gonna add a bush right here. Here, we're just gonna add bushes right there. Okay, I want pretty pink, of course. I want a pretty pink bush, so I'm grabbing some pink, a little bit of white. I'm gonna mix that together. Ooh, that's a pretty pink. Oh my God, that's pretty. Okay. And I'm just gonna tap that in. I have to wipe the brush because it's picking up the paint from underneath and you don't wanna mixed in. Got some orange ones and maybe some yellow ones. Okay, so same thing. Orange, some white. Mix that together. Tap it in here. Do a little wipe. Grab some more. Tap it in. Wipe it off. Wipe it off. And I think I want a yellow one. A little more pink. Okay, let's wipe the brush. A couple more things. So I want to add a little bit of detail to the back. So this is like a round, whatever you want to call it. And I'm gonna dip it into some thinner to loosen the bristles and also to grab some white paint. I wanna thin that out a little bit. Okay. And I want to pull the brush and twirl it out so that it could be pointy. And what I want to do is kind of line the edges of this mountain here. That'll give me some extra detail. This one's really far away, so we want these ones blurred. And just adding some detail to the background or the water. I think we're done with this painting for now, so there you have it. Nice mountain landscape. Easy. There's so much more you can do to this painting. You could highlight the trees a little more, do a little better with the bushes in the front. But overall, I think this came out pretty good. Thank you, everybody. Thank you for watching, and I hope that I will see you next time. Just adding some finishing touches. Thank you, everybody. Don't forget to like and subscribe.